In this episode, we're down here in the beautiful town of Grafton on the mighty Clarence River. Back in the early day when this was settled in the early 1800s, they used to know this river as the Big River. And you can see why, like it's massive, it's wide. Now Grafton has recently been bypassed by the new big interstate, the Pacific Motorway. If you're ever travelling between Brisbane and Sydney or vice versa, make sure you take the time to stop off at these little towns that have been bypassed. They've still got a lot to offer, and we're going to have a look at some of that today.
Grafton has a population of around 19,000 people. It's known for its tree-lined streets with jacaranda, mango, camphor laurel and Morton figs as some of the most beautiful varieties throughout the town. The Grafton Jacaranda Festival is held each year in November when the jacaranda are in their full purple glory.
Grafton is also the hometown of many famous Australians, including politicians, sports people, actors, musicians, and more. While many know that Russell Crowe currently lives down the road just south of Grafton, others know that Grafton is the childhood home of well-known country musicians Troy Cassar-Daly, the McClymont sisters Adam Eggersley, and also to rock legend Dan Walker of Cold Chisel. In fact, the iconic Australian song, Flame Trees, was written by Dan Walker about returning to his hometown of Grafton.
The Clarence River that divides South Grafton from Grafton has been both a blessing and a curse to the town at times during its 186 years of white settlement. The river provided for shipping, making Grafton an important shipping hub in the 1800s, and now serves as a place of recreation, sport and professional fishing. But the river has also claimed many lives in floods, storms and other hazards associated with its deceptively sleepy, broad waterway. There are a lot of cafes to choose from in Grafton. We chose to have lunch at the Sunrise on Turf and both had a chicken burger, which was great. Grafton also has an outstanding art gallery, which we didn't film in, and also the Clarence River Historical Society's Schaefer House Museum.
The museum itself is much larger than the exterior of the house would imply. Volunteers have lovingly maintained the home of early 20th century architect F.W.C. Schaefer. Each of the rooms contains furniture from Schaefer's home, plus donations from other locals whose history tells the story of life in Grafton during the early years.
So she had bought the netting,
yep,
and made this and the shams, like it's all hand done.
Wow.
Now that would have been done by candlelight, kerosene light.
Wow.
Yeah.
We were shown around the museum by Nita Childs, who, as we found out, happens to be a distant cousin of mine. Our common ancestors on this branch of our tree came out to Australia in the 1850s with a large extended family. They eventually made their home here in the Grafton, Southgate and Lawrence areas of the Clarence region. The family is huge and incorporates many well-known surnames in the Clarence and Richmond River districts. It was a pleasure to sit with Nita, who was very knowledgeable about our family tree on the Childs and Bailey branches. Thanks, Nita, that was great.
This museum is well worth the time and we could have easily spent more hours here as there's so much to look at. It's so well done. So we definitely recommend planning a visit to Schaefer House if you are in Grafton.
This is 1875 jewel box.
Oh, wow.
The attention to detail given by the volunteers of the Historical Society is second to none, and their knowledge of the history of the local area is impressive. A short drive north of Grafton is the quiet riverside village of Lawrence. Lawrence is also home to a great museum, which we hope to visit next time we're in the area. This spot is a great place to settle in for some quiet rest along the river, do some boating or fishing, or just soak up the peaceful country atmosphere.
Back in its heyday in the 1800s, Lawrence was also an important shipping port and served as a main junction of the mail runs, which served locations from Grafton to Lismore and even out to Tenerfield. Farming in the area includes dairy and beef and extensive sugarcane productions. Many people think of North Queensland when they think of sugarcane. But what many may not realise is that Australia's sugar industry began in New South Wales, with the first sugarcane being grown around Port Macquarie as early as 1821. Since then, the industry has spread north along Australia's tropical eastern seaboard, at times crowded out by urbanisation. Some of my ancestors were cane farmers and dairy farmers here in the Clarence region, the Richmond River region, and further north in Queensland around Bundaberg.
We stayed the night in a great little cottage called Adrian's Airbnb at Ulmurra. The cottage was very comfortable and beautifully decorated with tasteful renovations and furnishings. The host provided popcorn, which we ate while we watched this evening show, A Storm, which was a welcome relief after a hot and humid day. Thanks for watching. In the morning, we'll be heading north toward one of our favourite seaside towns, Yamba.